Hello everyone, this is Imran Pardesi sir and today I will be starting standard 8th maths chapter number 1, that is rational and irrational numbers. My dear students, before starting this topic, what is rational numbers and what is irrational numbers, first I would like to take you to the previous knowledge, the basic of these numbers. Please look at the board. See here, the topic of standard 8 number 1 is rational and irrational numbers. Okay, so first we will start with some basic knowledge. See here, the previous knowledge, here you can see a capital N. Capital N denotes the natural numbers. Okay, so which starts? Okay, the natural number starts from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So on means cannot be determined. Okay, now look at here. Capital W denotes the whole numbers. Okay, so now the whole number starts from, whole means it is already indicates something, whole means 0. So it will starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, cannot be determined, so on. It means we cannot say till which limit. Okay, now see, so I for integers. Okay, so integers, as you can see here on this board, the number, what is integers? Okay, so collective form of origin, positive numbers and negative numbers are called integers. Okay, I repeat, what is integers? The collective form, it means origin is there. See, this is a number line. Okay, you have seen in previous classes as well, in standard 6th and standard 7th also you have seen. So this, the middle part is 0, that is origin. The middle part is 0, it is origin. The numbers which are on your right hand side, they are 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. It means they are in increasing order and all these numbers on right hand side will be positive. Okay, it is increasing. Now can you see here on the left hand side, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. These numbers are decreasing. Remember, these numbers on left hand side are decreasing. So minus 1 and minus 4, who is bigger? Who is bigger, minus 1 or minus 4? Minus 1 is bigger. Why? Because left hand side all numbers are decreasing. Okay, if two numbers are in negative sign, like see, minus 2 and minus 3, who is bigger? Minus 2 is bigger. Why? Because the left hand side on number, on a number line, all numbers are decreasing. Is it clear? And these all numbers towards the left hand side are in negative form. I hope you understood the number line. Okay, so these counting numbers, okay, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, you know now integer means what? Collective form of origin plus positive numbers and negative numbers together form a group, that is called integer. Okay, so now see here, the topic name is rational and irrational number. So first we will learn about the rational number. So can you see here, rational numbers denoted by here capital Q. So capital Q means rational numbers. So what is rational number? So my dear students, if you, do you know the fraction? Okay, you have learned fraction from 3rd and 4th standard. So you have seen the fraction. Okay, like here, look at here. Suppose there is your 20 marks paper and you got 18. So this is a rational number. Why? Because here the fraction has numerator upon denominator. Is it clear? So this is a, in short, this is a rational number. So pay attention towards the definition of a rational number. If m is any integer, if m is any integer, integer means what? Maybe it will be positive, maybe it will be negative, or maybe it will be zero also. Okay, and n is any non-zero integer, it means the denominator will not be 0. Okay, denominator will not be 0. It will be non-zero integer. Integer means positive number or negative number, but it will not be non-zero. Matlab 0 nahi hoga. Okay, so the number m upon n is called a rational number. It means the fraction which has numerator upon denominator is called a rational number, and rational number denoted by capital Q. Okay, so example, can you see here, 5 upon 2, numerator is 5 upon denominator is 2. So this is a fraction, yes, this is a rational number. Now see here, minus 3 upon 2, minus 3 upon 7, This is also integer upon natural number, right? Or whole number. So minus 3 upon 7, it is also a rational number. Minus 25 upon 4, it is also a rational number. Now see, focus here, it is only 7. And this is only 4. And this is only 10. So why they are also rational number? See, the note is here. Every number is a rational number. It means, har number rational hoga. Every number will be rational number. How? So this is 7 only. But this 7 we can write as 7 upon 1. If you will see, there is a number only. The number, it does not have a denominator. 7 ke niche denominator nahi hai. It means what? You can say 7 upon 1. It means this is a rational number. Okay, so we don't write denominator 1. So we will write it only 7. So this is 4. But 4 we have to write 4 upon 1. But we don't write denominator 1. So this is 4 upon 1. You will say, sir, there is no denominator. It means the definition is m upon n. And here is only m. But n is not there. So what we will say? No, every number is a rational number means it has denominator 1. This 4 is also has denominator 1. This 10 is also has denominator 1. It means the note is saying every number is a rational number. I hope you understood here. Okay. So now we will see the next topic of this chapter. I hope you understood till this here. So dear students, now we will see how to solve the practice set 1.1, question number 1. My dear students, in 6th standard also you have done this question, that how to show the given rational numbers on a number line. So please look at the board here. See, the topic is how to show any number on a number line. So you know very well, first we have to draw a number line. First you will draw a number line. How you will draw a number line? In between, you will take 0, that is as an origin, right? 0. Then you will go right hand side, all the numbers will be increasing, positive, 1, 2, 3, 4, right, and so on. And on left hand side, all numbers will be negative, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, like that, okay. But focus here, which numbers you have to show on the number line, okay. So by watching, by observing these numbers, see I can say 1, 3 and this 5. So which is maximum number towards the right hand side will be 5. Which is bigger number? 1, 3 or 5? 5. So you will go on right hand side till 5 number comes. See how? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Right? Now see on the left hand side. Which number is negative? Only one number, that is minus 3. So that you will go to the left hand side till minus 3 only. Okay? Don't waste your time. The numbers which you want to show on the number line, You have to draw that much line only. Don't waste your time. Okay? Be smart. So what I will do on left hand side, all numbers will be negative. I will draw minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Right? Okay? So distance between these, you can keep the scale. Okay? See like this. You will keep the scale. And then you will give after 1, 1 or 2, 2 dots. Right? Okay? So you have to draw. You have to show the numbers on the number line. But always draw first line. Then show 0, that is origin, in between, okay, in between you will show the origin, and then on right hand side all numbers will be positive, increasing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on left hand side negative, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on. But don't waste your time, the numbers which you have to show till that time only, till that you have to show the numbers. See, now can you observe that every number has a denominator over here is 4, minus 3 upon 4, minus 1 upon 4, 3 upon 4, 5 upon 4. It means every number has a denominator 4. So you must give them denominator 4. See, 2 upon 4, this is 4, this is 4, this is 4. Okay? So now, here also, left hand side also, you will give minus 1 upon 4, minus 2 upon 4, minus 3 upon 4. Okay? Because here, every number has a denominator 4. So now, the numbers which we have to show on the number line, we will highlight them. Hum unko highlight karenge. So which is first, minus 3 upon 4. So this is here on left hand side. So either you can make circle like this, or either you can make a circle like this. No problem. Okay? Only you have to show. These numbers are where? Now see, 1 upon 4 you can show here by like this also, or otherwise you can show like this also. Okay, some are making rectangle as well. See, 3 upon 4 is here. So I will show like this also. Okay, no problem. Now see, 5 upon 4 is here. So I will show like this and like this also. No problem. Is it clear? Only you have to show, you have to choose any one method. Either you want to show like this. If you want to make a circle, make a circle. Okay, now see, the practice set 1.1, question number 1 is show on the number line. What? Number 1, 3 upon 2, it is a rational number. 5 upon 2, it is a rational number. Minus 3 upon 2, it is a rational number. What is a rational number? A fraction which has numerator and denominator. Okay, and every number is a rational number. So if you will see a single number also, it is a rational number because it has denominator 1. Okay, now see here, show on number line. First I will draw a number line. Okay, first I will draw the number line. Then I will show the 0 in between origin. Okay, then towards the right hand side, all numbers will be positive. So see, which number is bigger, 3 or 5? 5. So we will go till 5. Like 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, enough. Then which number is negative, minus 3. So you will go till minus 3. That is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. I told you here decreasing. Here all the numbers are decreasing. It means minus 1 and minus 3. Who is bigger? Minus 1 is bigger. Why? Because all numbers are decreasing towards the left hand side. So now we have to show 3 upon 2. So can you observe here every number has a denominator 2? Yes. So you also put denominator 2. Is it clear? Okay, now you will show one by one. 3 upon 2 is here, so I want to show like this, so I will make like this. Okay, 5 upon 2 is here, so I will show like this. No problem. Minus 3 upon 2 is here, so I will show like this. Okay, so use any one method. Make circle, to circle, complete circle, complete circle. If you want to make the rectangle or square box, you can make it. No problem, but your answer should be clear. Now see here, this is question number 2, 7 upon 5. So first I will draw a number line. First I will draw the number line. In between I will write origin 0, 7. 7 is a positive number. It means on the right hand side I will go till 7. Seedhe haath ki taraf I will go till 7. See now. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now on left hand side minus 2 and minus 4. So you will go till minus 4. Okay. See here, left hand side minus 1. Minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Every number has a denominator 5. Okay, so you will give 5, 2 upon 5, 1 upon 5, 3 upon 5, 4 upon 5. So like this only I will show the numbers on the number line. Is it clear? Now 7 upon 5, it is on the right hand side, it is positive number, so I will show like this. Okay, now see next, minus 2 upon 5, it is on the left hand side because it is negative number, right? So I will show here. Now minus 4 upon 5, it is here, negative number on the left hand side, I will show like this. So this is how you all will solve, you all will show the numbers on the number line. Is it clear? The rest questions will be homework to you. I hope you will do question number 2. Please pay attention, it is very much easy. Just focus on the given number line and do some needful changes and answer the given question. Please look at the board. See here. Question number 2 is observe the number line and answer the questions. Okay, so we have to observe this number line. So my dear students, my first question to you is, see, this middle part is called O for origin. This is 0, right? But 0 after there is a dash. See, dash, 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 then 1. Is it possible? There is some errors are there. Look at here. 0 after here should be 1. Then 2, then 3, then 4, right? But can you see here on this number line, there is a gap. O and F, between O and F, there is a gap. It means we have to write something over there. What you will write? See, 0 after 1, 1 after 2, 2 after 3, it means here it was 4, okay, but why this 1 is written over here, why? It means there is a four number the gap, okay? So this 1, 2, 3, and 4, it means this 4 is divisible by 4 only, that's why this become 1. 4 ones are 4, so answer came 1. Do you understand this? Suppose this 1 would be here, agar ye 1 yahan par hota to 0 after 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, it means the every number has a denominator 5. Is it clear? Suppose if here the 1 would be here, agar ye 1 yahan par hota to 0 after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it means 6 upon 6 it becomes 1. Why? 6 ones are 6, 6 ones are 6. I hope you understood. Okay, so my dear students, now I will tell you that here it was, the given number line was having 1 here below the F. Okay, it means you can say point F is having coordinate 1. It means here it is a gap. So what you have to do, some changes, you have to write something with the pencil. Okay, so 0 after it will be 1, then 1 after 2, then 2 after 3, then how it comes 1? It means here 4 was there, wahan pe 4 tha, and how it become 1? Because 4 upon 4 will become 1. Why? Because 4 times table 4 comes, 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4, so answer came 1. I hope you understood. Now here 5, because here it was 4, so 5, 6, 7, and how it become 2? Because here every number has a 4. See, every number has here 4, denominator 4. Every number has a denominator 4. So this 8 also has denominator 4. So can you read that 4 times table? 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So therefore this 2 came here. I hope you understood how it is simplified. It gets simplified. See now this 8. Now 8 after 9, 10, 11. So 9 upon 4. 10 upon 4, 11 upon 4, so here it is 12 upon 4. Read the 4 times table, 4 ones are 4, 4 threes are 12. I hope you understood. Now here it is 13 upon 4. So first, the given number line we will observe and we will write some missing numbers over there. See now, towards the left hand side, 0, after there is a gap, and after the gap there is a minus 1. How? See, 0 after here it will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Then how it became again minus 1? It means 1, 2, 3, 4. It means here it was minus 4 upon 4. So this gate cancelled and it became minus 1. Every number, it means every number has over there 4, denominator 4. Can you see here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4? Minus 4 upon 4 became minus 1. Okay, now go forward. Minus 5 upon 4, minus 6 upon 4, minus 7 upon 4. Okay, now see here minus 2. How? Because here it was minus 8 upon 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. Therefore, it became minus 2. I hope you understood. Now see here 8 after minus 9 upon 4. Minus 10 upon 4, minus 11 upon 4, minus 12 upon 4, which gets simplified by 4 times table. 4 ones are 4, 4 threes are 12. I hope you understood. Now here again minus 13 upon 4. I hope you understood. Okay, now by observing this number line, we will write the answer of these questions. Look at here. Which number is indicated by point B? Where is point B? Here. So which number is indicated by point B? Just tell me. So you will write minus 10 upon 4 is indicated by point B. Simple. I hope you understood here how to write the answer. Okay. Now see which point indicates the number. Here it is different. 1 is 1 and 3 upon 4. How to read this? 1 and 3 upon 4. So first we will convert this. First you should know this is a mixed fraction. Okay, this is a mixed fraction. So what you will do? You will read 4 times table till 1. 4 ones are, you will read the 4 times table till 1. 4 ones are 4. And this 3 you will add. This 3 you will add in that 4. 4 ones are 4. Add this 3. That is 5, 6, 7. 7 upon 4. So this mixed fraction will get converted into 7 upon 4. Look at here. So I will write here 1 and 3 upon 4 is equals to 4 ones are 4 plus 3. 5, 6, 7. 7 upon 4. Okay, so 7 upon 4 is where? Can you please tell me which point indicates the number 1 and 3 upon 4? So this is 1 and 3 upon 4 is equals to 7 upon 4. Therefore, we can see where is 7 upon 4? It is here. Where is 7 upon 4? It is there. Okay, so which point indicates the number 1 and 3 upon 4? So you will write the answer. Point C indicates, point C indicates the number 1 and 3 upon 4. I hope you understood. You know how to convert this mixed fraction into a like fraction, into a real fraction. Okay. Now see the next step. Whether the statement the point D denotes the number 5 upon 2 is true or false. Where is point D? Okay. Point D is here. So point D is how much? Point D has 10 upon 4. Can you see here? Point D has the coordinate 10 upon 4. So can you, this gets simplified by 2 times table. 2 2's are 4, 2 5's are 10. So which is equals to 5 upon 2? Yes. Okay. So what you will do here? See this 2 2's are this 10 and this 4. 2 2's are 4, 2 5's are 10. Which is equals to 5 upon 2. Yes. So we will write here. This statement is true. This statement is true. I hope you understood. So this is how we have to solve the practice set 1.2. Question number 1.2. Okay, sorry. Question, we have to solve the practice set 1.1. Question number 2. I hope you understood. This is how we will solve practice set 1.1, question number 2. It is very much easy. I hope you understood. Best of luck and thank you so much.